Hi guys, and I am finally back Monday. You didn't have to wait that long. That's good. So, here's my second football video in the channel, finally. Why am I saying finally so much? Okay, today it is going to be MLS Monday. Although I'm covering this, I am filming this in Sunday. So I'll miss two games. And don't tell anyone. Okay, first game, New Year, and by the way, I am covering all of match day 24. So a lot of games that I'm gonna cover. This is gonna be a long video. Alrighty, 1 minute. Okay. New York City versus Columbus Crew. That one ended 1-0. The only goal coming in the 37th minute when Valentin Castellanos sent a right footed shot from the center of the box into the bottom left corner. An assist by Maximiliano Morales with a through ball. So, 1-0, that's how it ended. Then, next match, DC United versus New York Red Bulls. And the New York Red Bulls won 2-1. Now, I was like, I don't really think the New York Red Bulls are a pretty good team. I mean, no. I guess they are, and they're pretty high up in the table right now in the Eastern or Western standings. Why do they have Eastern and Western standings or groups? That's just stupid, man. Okay. First goal came from Alejandro Romero from New York Red Bulls in the 6th minute. Then another one in the 55th minute. Yep. By Ola Camara, I don't know how to pronounce that, from DC United. And then the New York Red Bulls were awarded a penalty in the 58th minute because of a foul in the box by Lucas Rodriguez. And Daniel Royer converted that penalty, so 2-1, final goal of the match. That's how it ended. I'm just gonna go through these matches real quick. Los Angeles FC versus San Jose Earthquakes, which ended 4-0. Los Angeles FC winning. Sporting Kansas City versus Minnesota United, 1-0. Sporting Kansas winning. Portland Timbers versus Seattle Sounders, which ended 2-1, went to Seattle Sounders. Then New England Revolution versus Chicago Fire, which ended 2-1, New England Revolution winning. By the way, I've never heard of New England Revolution, never before. I just went to research this, and I've never heard of them. I guess they're new, pretty new. I know the MLS is adding a lot of teams, so I think they're new. And so let's keep going. Then Philadelphia Union, which I've also never heard of, versus DC United. And Philadelphia Union won 3-1. Real Salt Lake, I was about to say Real, I don't know why. Real Salt Lake versus Colorado Rapids. And Real Salt Lake won 2-0. San Jose Earthquakes versus the Vancouver Whitecaps, which ended 3-1 to the San Jose Earthquakes. And then we're going to Orlando City versus Atlanta United. Orlando City, also never heard of them. I've gone to Orlando before. I liked it. Atlanta United, probably the best team in the MLS right now. So I was gonna cover this one, Joseph Martinez, the Venezuelan, got the goal in the 60th minute, and that's how it ended, 1-0 to America United. So, New York City FC versus New York Red Bull. I'm thinking, is this like, do they have a rivalry? Because they're both from New York. I don't know. I haven't really watched many MLS games before, and so I can't. I've never watched games from either of these two teams, so I don't really know if they have a rivalry. If they do, then I wouldn't know about it. So, yeah. And New York City FC won this one 2-1. But the first goal did not come to New York City FC, but to New York Red Bull. And why did Red Bull? In the 10th minute, an assist by Alejandro Romero, goal by Alex Mill. And then there was a penalty. By the way, these penalties are the first ones that I've covered in my video, so important. And so there was a penalty for New York City FC, which was given when Michael Murillo fouled in the penalty box, of course. And Maximilian Morales converted penalty. 1-1, he tied it up. And then just 10 minutes later, Heber got the last goal of the game, 52nd minute. And that was how it ended. Then Toronto FC versus Montreal Impact, 2-1, and Toronto won. And FC Cincinnati versus Columbus Crew, and 3-1, Columbus Crew won. And now we are going to the tables, two of them. Group East, Group West. And so for Group East, first place with 48 points, that's a lot. 48 points is pretty good. I thought this MLS season had just started, but I guess I'm used to the Europe seasons. Although I do live in the United States, I don't really watch that much MLS. So, Atlanta United, first place. Philadelphia Union, 48 points, second place. And so, New York City FC, 47 points, third place. Fourth place is New York Red Bulls, 41 points. Sixth is New England Revolution, 38 points. Seventh, Toronto FC, 37 points. Eighth, Montreal Impact, 34 points. 9th, Orlando City with 34 points. 10th, Chicago Fire with 33 points. 11th, Columbus Crew with 30 points. And at last, 12th place, Cincinnati, FC Cincinnati, with only 18 points. They're really bad, guys. They are 12 points off 11th place. That is bad. Group West is first place Los Angeles FC. I was really surprised by this. I think Los Angeles FC is also pretty new. They're pretty good. 61 points. And next second place, Real Salt Lake. It's 43 points home. Second place team is 18 points off first place team. That's a lot of points to be between first place and second place. So, you can tell how good Los Angeles FC is. Third place is Seattle Sounders, 43 points. They're a pretty good team. Also in the race for being the best team. Fourth is Minnesota United, 42 points. Fifth is LA Galaxy, 41 points. Sixth, San Jose Earthquakes, 41 points. 7th, FC Dallas, 38 points. 8th, Portland Timbers. I always make this mistake. I always say Timbers, and it's Timbers. I'm just used to saying it, I guess. I don't know why. So, Portland Timbers, 37 points, 8th place. 9th place, Sporting Kansas City, 34 points. 10th place, Houston Dynamo, 2 points. And I'm pretty sad about this, because if you didn't know, I live in Houston. I've never mentioned it before, so you shouldn't know, except my friends, my family, or whatever. Or hear hackers. I don't know. And so they have 32 points. 11th place, Colorado Rapids, 27 points. And 12th place, at last place, Vancouver Whitecaps FC, 27 points. I thought they were better. And that's really the longest video I've made in this channel. 11 minutes. Well, bye guys. Today, I didn't talk about any of the big Europe leagues. But talked about MLS Monday. Although I am, again, filming this in Sunday. But, bye guys. Long live Barcelona.